This video is based on an investigation report produced by the Australian Transport Safety Bureau, published on November 29, 2024. All aircraft displays are simulated based on ADS-B and flight data recorder information, and conversations have been reconstructed. Welcome to Brisbane Airport. It's just after 1600 hours local time on Wednesday, September 6, 2023. As Virgin Australia Flight 336 departs for a 2-hour 20-minute trip to Melbourne. The flight is being operated today by a Boeing 737-800, registered Victor Hotel Yankee Quebec Romeo, which was first delivered to Virgin Australia in 2013. For this flight, the captain is performing the pilot monitoring duties, and the first officer is performing the pilot flying duties. The takeoff and departure are uneventful, and the aircraft turns to the south and begins climbing to cruising altitude, flight level 380. But what seems like a routine flight will soon take a surprising turn. Here's what happened. At flight level 370, the crew are engaged in conversation, and a member of the cabin crew calls to request access into the flight deck.
Hey guys, got some afternoon tea for you.
After completing the requisite security procedures, the pilot monitoring looks over and reaches across the center aisle stand for the flight deck door switch. Just prior to grasping the switch, however, the captain transfers their gaze from the aisle stand to the door at the rear of the flight deck. In doing so, they inadvertently grasp and at 16:25 and 22 seconds activate the nearby rudder trim control to the full left position. Both pilots feel the aircraft briefly roll and yaw.
You feel that?
Yeah, a little yaw there.
Everything looks okay here.
Before we go any further, let's discuss. What is rudder trim? Trim refers to adjustments made to the aircraft's control surfaces to maintain a desired flight attitude without requiring constant input from the pilot or autopilot. These adjustments help reduce pilot workload and improve the aircraft's stability during flight. Rudder trim specifically is used to adjust the rudder's position to counteract any unwanted yawing tendencies caused by factors such as engine torque, crosswinds, or asymmetrical lift. This makes for a more comfortable and efficient flight. Trimming the rudder for minimum drag is a normal and regularly practiced procedure, mostly used early in the cruise phase of flight. Back on the flight deck, the captain looks forward and outside the aircraft, then scans the instrument panel, while continuing to maintain the input on the rudder trim control. The first officer scans their instruments and notes that the position trend vector on the navigation display has begun to indicate a slight left turn. With neither pilot identifying anything abnormal, the captain looks back at the door, waiting for it to open, while maintaining the full left rudder trim control selection. The autopilot, trying to maintain the pre-programmed route, responds to the increasing left rudder trim and resultant left yaw with an opposing and increasing right wing down aileron input. This input is replicated on the control column's control wheel. Despite this increasing input, a slight left bank begins to develop. After 5 seconds of full left rudder trim input, the autopilot's application of aileron input reaches the limit of its authority, 22 degrees right wing down position. The aircraft, however, still has a left roll bank angle of about 5 degrees. As the left rudder trim input continues, and with the autopilot unable to apply any further counter input, the aircraft's left roll increases.
Are we supposed to be turning?
No.
The pilot monitoring releases the rudder trim control 8 seconds after first applying the input. About 5 degrees of left rudder displacement has been applied, and the aircraft is now banked about 10 degrees to the left. Due to the significant rudder displacement, the aircraft's left bank angle begins to rapidly increase. Passing 25 degrees, the pilot flying attempts to counter the turn using the heading select mode and heading changes on the mode control panel. This has no effect. With the bank angle increasing towards 35 degrees, the pilot flying announces,
"My aircraft,"
and disconnects the autopilot. Almost simultaneously, the pilot flying briefly applies about 2/3 deflection of the control wheel right wing down input to oppose the left roll. the aircraft's ground proximity warning system bank angle alert is activated as the aircraft passes 35 degrees bank.
Bank angle.
Upset.
Upset, applying right aileron to correct.
The large application of right wing down roll stops and then reverses the left roll, but not before the aircraft attains 42 degrees left bank angle. The aircraft recovers to an approximate wings level attitude of less than 10 degrees bank angle about 18 seconds after the rudder trim input was first applied. The pilot flying applies right bank with the intent to regain tracking. Both pilots immediately initiate troubleshooting, with the initial focus on an engine-related issue. The pilot flying maintains about 35 degrees of right wing down control wheel displacement to maintain an approximate wings level attitude. While the pilot monitoring checks for the cause of the upset, the pilot flying calls for the rudder trim to be checked, as there were no other alerts or other apparent sources causing the large roll input. The pilot monitoring checks the trim indicator and identifies the inadvertently applied trim. At 16, 26 and 34 seconds, right rudder trim is applied to neutralize the rudder position. During this time, the cabin crew had commenced food service. Due to the movement of the aircraft during the upset, a cabin crew member at the rear of the aircraft sustained a minor injury while stabilizing a cart. The aircraft continued to Melbourne and landed at 18:08 hours without further incident. We're going to watch a real-time replay shortly, but before that, let's discuss some context and the ATSB's findings. The captain had extensive experience, with 19,500 hours of total flight time, including 13,500 hours on the 737. The first officer had 2,700 hours of flight experience, with 350 hours on the 737. Both pilots held appropriate qualifications and medical certifications. No indicators were found that suggested fatigue was a contributing factor to the incident. The captain ensured all trim controls were checked during the pre-flight. The operator's manual required procedures for safety-critical systems, but this did not include the flight deck door lock switch. However, it did mandate that controls or switches should not be changed without positive visual identification. The operator's manual recommended using rudder trim mainly to reduce drag, and warned of sideslip-induced roll, which could lead to a rapid roll rate and an uncoordinated flight state. The contributing factors are listed as follows. The pilot monitoring inadvertently selected the rudder trim switch instead of the door switch, applying rudder trim for 8 seconds. The autopilot initially compensated for the yaw and roll caused by the rudder trim, but reached its roll authority limit after 5 seconds, leading to a rapid increase in roll. The flight crew were not able to promptly identify the yaw as the primary cause of the upset, delaying the correction of the issue, preventing a timely return to balanced flight. In response to the incident, Virgin Australia implemented several safety actions. The flight deck door unlock procedure was modified to ensure clearer indication of crew readiness, thereby limiting the time the switch is held in the unlock position. A briefing on the event was given to flight crews, and updates were made to the non-technical skills program. I hope you found this fascinating. Let me know what you think of this different format, and don't forget to subscribe for more aviation insights. I'll leave you with a real-time replay of the event unfolding.
Bank angle.